Stadium, a packed house where the top-ranked team in the land has won 15 straight games. It's number one Oregon against number 21 Arizona in a Pac-10 battle. We have had rain on and off most of the day. Right now, showers 46 degrees. It'll work its way under 40 by about halftime, and we expect the showers to continue as well. Take a look at the Pac-10 standings. Oregon, the number one team in the country, obviously number one in their conference as well. Arizona, 7-3, looking for another eight-win season under Mike Stoops. Chip Kelly, just his second season, and right now he's got his team close to a BCS berth. A win tonight would put him there, and of course, a national championship is still a possibility if they win this one and then win the Civil War next week. Mike Stoops, seventh season as Arizona's head coach. As I mentioned, back-to-back eight-win seasons. They can get an eighth win if they pull this one off tonight. Brad Nessler with Ty Blackledge and Holly Rowe. Arizona won the toss and deferred, so we'll see the high-powered offense of Oregon to start the ball game. And we're underway. Kick goes to the sixth to Huff, the freshman. Broke one tackle but can't reach the 20-yard line. So coming out, Darren Thomas. Had a sensational season so far, the sophomore out of Houston, Texas.
I think he'll be ready to kind of redeem himself. He didn't have a very good game last week, or their last time out against Cal. Cal played almost all man coverage, and he missed some throws that he'd been making the rest of the season. I mean, he has had a marvelous season, a third-year sophomore, first-time starter.
And with him in the backfield, the leading rusher in the country, LaMichael James. Thomas comes up throwing on first down. Fires, tips, and almost intercepted by Shaquille Richardson.
Arizona very aware of how they have to play on defense.
Some tight ends in this situation on a second down and four. Now Thomas up and down the line to let everybody know the upcoming play. He'll give it off to LaMichael James. On the corner and got the corner. Now looking for a block to take it all the way. Whoa, just going to run head on to Richardson. And he comes up, wings flat.
Well, you can't miss tackles. That's one thing that Mike Stoops said we can't do. And right away, there's a missed tackle. An unblocked defender, the corner, Robert Golden, missed the tackle. And LaMichael James turned it into a big play.
Down to the 27-yard line where it's first down. Thomas rolling left. The man in his face just lets it fly out of bounds and almost to the stands. Second down and 10 at the 27. James only got a yard, maybe a yard and a half. Joseph Perkins from the secondary made the hit. That'll bring up third down and long.
The reason that I thought this would be the best defensive team that Oregon has faced is because they are built, Arizona's defense is built to play this offense better than the two they just lost to in their last two games. USC and Stanford, more a downhill power running team. This is more of an east-west spread you out kind of team.
Oregon 47% on their third down conversions this year. Thomas back to throw. His pocket gives him time. It's intercepted. Hall goes the other way. And only the seventh interception of Darren Thomas this year. And there's that defense that Todd was talking about.
Thomas had time to throw, but I think he kind of stared his receiver down. Once he got into the middle, he stared it down, and his safety was able to get a great break on the football.
Antolin on the handoff, and he gets drilled by the Ducks defense and a loss of a yard. Brandon Bear was the first guy there, and he had help from his friends. Nick Foles at the controls. For Arizona, 71% completion on the year. Second down and 11.
A lot of quick throws out of this offense. A lot of screens. Hard to get to him because the ball comes out of his hands pretty quick.
They keep it on the ground and they get out to the 44 with Yola Antolin. And Casey Matthews, the linebacker, made the stop. So third down coming up for Arizona.
The guy to watch in this pass offense, besides the quarterback Foles, is their wide receiver, Jerron Kreiner, the top receiver in the Pac-10, number 82. This is him down here on the bottom. Big-time player.
Number one in the Pac-10 in receiving and yardage of receptions. The throw is caught And it's David Douglas for a first down and a good catch. Pick up of 15.
They like to play tempo from their four wide receiver set. They don't do it as much as Oregon. They don't do it with all their personnel groups. But when they have four receivers in the game, they like to hurry it up a little bit.
Nick Grigsby's in the lineup for the first time at the tailback spot. Foles, nice play fake. And he goes deep middle, incomplete. Intended for Totogo. Arizona came in. They only had 8 interceptions on the season coming in. The 9th one they got on Oregon's opening drive could turn into points if they can keep this going at the Ducks 30-yard line. Going to toss it out to Antolin. And he's got a lot of guys chasing him, and he's not even going to get the line of scrimmage. Great pursuit by the Ducks defensively, and Josh Kadu, one of the captains, a loss of 1 on the tackle. If you're looking for a team to huddle tonight, you're watching the wrong game. Neither team will. This isn't your dad's Oldsmobile type offense on either side. Third down and 11. Foles, plenty of time down the middle, and he throws a strike inside the 20 to Terrence Miller, the tight end. They're at the 14 right now, though. And they'll run it with Grigsby. And he powers for what he can, a pickup of about 3. Arizona's not only keeping the high-powered Ducks on the sideline, they're going down the field themselves. They've used 5 minutes. Grigsby again. Nice second effort. It'll be about 2 yards shy of the first down. Antolin comes in. Grigsby goes out. Bowles lobs it. Got it in the corner. And the field judge says touchdown. Jerron Crotter, his first catch of the night. Good for an 8-yard score.
As a quarterback, you don't have to be super nimble or super fast, but you have to be able to buy yourself some time and extend the play. Now, the key on that one was his left foot, or his right foot down when he caught the football, because the one foot looked like it touched the line as he was going out of bounds.
And he's got it up and good. A 60-yard drive that took 7 minutes and 42 seconds, and lo and behold, number 21 Arizona early on the top-ranked team in the country.
As that was, they need to cover every kick because the returners for Oregon are outstanding.
This time they just squib it short, and Casey Matthews, the middle linebacker, picked it up and got a nice return. A good starting field position here at the 44-yard line for the Ducks. Play action, Thomas wants a bunch, wide open man, it'll be an Oregon touchdown. To David Paulson, the tight end.
It doesn't take him long. Paulson came in short motion and then just disappears behind the back of the Arizona defense. A busted coverage. The guy who made the interception, Adam Hall, on the first possession, that time got burnt for the touchdown.
Bob Beard in for the point after as they spread out their formation and now bring it all back together for the extra point. And it's up and good. 7-7, Darren Thomas with a touchdown pass to a wide-open tight end.
Well, you have 2 defenders for Arizona, and one of them has to take the tight end. As he runs this route, neither one of these guys covers him. They both are influenced by the play fake. They both come rushing up towards the ball, and they leave a guy behind them for an easy touchdown. Can't give easy scores to a team like Oregon.
Turner, he's got to hustle up. Oop, somebody's going to take it in front of him, actually, and that was Jenkins. And now he's going the wrong way. From the 15-yard line. Play action. Foles wants a bunch on first down. Got a man open. Got him. 85 yards. Touchdown, Crotter. He's going to trot in and hand it to the back judge. How about that for a one-play drive? And that throw, Foles got it right out there where he could run under it. And he had to use every stride that he had to get to it. Longest play from scrimmage this year for Arizona. Zendejas for the point after. And it's up and good.
How do you attack an aggressive corner? Double moves. Watch this. Sell it. Pause. Whoops.
Oof.
And nobody helping behind. You know, a guy like Cliff Harris is going to go for picks. He's going to try to read that route. And it was perfectly executed by Kreiner, and then Foles gave him the football.
I said he was going to be a Tommy Hilfiger impact guy. I didn't say which way he was going to impact the game.
Well, you also said Kreiner was an impact player too, right?
Yeah, and he's got a couple already. But now to kick off again. This time they kick deep instead of the squib job they had last time that didn't work for him. Josh Huff from about the 11-yard line. And Huff's got an opening. And he's out across the 45. Not near the 48-yard line. And back up to the ball. James on a sweep. Got cartwheeled, but he got about seven before Shaquille Richardson made the stop. There's Oregon with those placards they use over there to call plays at times. They just put it down when we went to it, but they've got all kinds of signals, pictures, different things on those cards over there. And there's your audible. Second down and three. Straight up the middle. Michael James, not the biggest guy in the world, but he's pretty powerful, deceivingly so.
Most of his runs are in between the tackles. Now, he's got the speed to get outside and break big runs. But he's a lot tougher than I think people give him credit for running inside.
Already has a 38-yard run to his credit tonight, but that one was just straight up the gut to pick up the needed yardage for the first down, and they've got it just inside the Wildcat 32-yard line. James again on the left side, follows his blockers, puts his head down, still on his feet. Great run that time. Showing speed, showing power. Show a little bit of guts at the end of it.
Well, this is a gut check for this offense. Last week, 29 carries, 91 yards for LaMichael James, only 162 yards rushing for the team. And this is a team that coming into tonight averages almost 300 yards a game rushing. So they're trying to get that back on track here early in this ballgame.
Oregon scored 33 touchdowns in the red zone this year. They're back in it at the 17-yard line trying to tie this game up with 20 seconds remaining first quarter. James again, straight up the middle. And that might be the final play of the quarter. You never know with them. It only takes them about 20 seconds to get a playoff. They might get one more snap here, and they will. And it's LaMichael James. Lost his headgear on that one. But he got it down inside the 10-yard line. That's where the Ducks will have it to start the second quarter, trailing by a touchdown when we come back. Great night. You're a Duck. It's raining. It's about 45 degrees. Right now they're driving. The eighth play of their drive coming up that has only taken them about 3 minutes to get down inside the 10-yard line of Arizona, but a big third down coming up.
Now their last scoring drive was more typical of Oregon. Four plays, 60 yards. Didn't take very long. This one a more methodical drive, but they need a conversion here on third and short.
Kenyon Barner joins Thomas in the backfield. Paulson, the tight end, on the move. And it will be Barner. And we're not going to get there.
Nope.
Adam Hall, who had an interception in the first quarter, makes the tackle on that one. So maybe decision time for Chip Kelly here is going to be fourth down and a yard.
They brought Paulson in motion to be the lead blocker on that play, but excellent penetration by the defensive front of Arizona knocked Paulson right back into the backfield.
Well, they didn't even flinch about going for it here on fourth down. Fourth down, about a yard and a half. Again, Paulson on the move. And again, Barner, and this time he's got it.
Same kind of play, just run it to the other side. You still bring Paulson in motion. He's your lead blocker. And Barner just kind of gets in his hip pocket and fights for the first down.
Mike Stoops looking up at that scoreboard to watch the replay.
Paulson gets a real nice block on Brooks Reed, knocks him to the inside, and Barner cut right outside of him.
Now the Ducks have got three tight ends in there with one in motion. Play action. Thomas pulls up. Touchdown in the back of the end zone to Jeff Mayle. Second scoring toss of the night now for Thomas.
Boy, when he threw this, I thought there's a lot of traffic in there, but he stuck that football in perfectly to Mayo. I mean, perfect lead on the throw in between three Arizona defenders. Cannot do it any better than that.
6 yard scoring toss, the 12th touchdown catch of the year for Mayo. Beard for the point after. Up and good. But Jeff Mayo, one of the 23 seniors, playing his final game at Outzen Stadium. Waits on number one, crosses the back of the end zone, and he's got it for the touchdown. 3 years ago, this guy was a safety. Now he's moving up the career charts, his 24th receiving touchdown. Tied for first in school history, and he continues his single-season school record that he's already got. He's got 12 this year alone.
Something about a receiver being dependable. As a quarterback, you know he's going to be there and he's going to catch it when you give it to him. You like those guys.
Beard's kick. Mike Turner will camp under it at the 5 yard line. And Turner is going to have to fight to get to the 20, and he's not going to get there. Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, guys, the last time this Oregon defense was on the field, they gave up a disastrous play after some miscommunication in the secondary. So when they came to the sidelines, it was a healthy but very animated discussion going on. The guys are saying stuff like, hey, I thought you were going to be here. No, you were supposed to be here. They were going back and forth, but in a healthy way, guys. They're trying to get things straightened out, particularly their corner, number 13. He just was lost on that play, but they think they've got it settled down.
Holly, I'm glad you brought those galoshes of yours, the multicolored leopard print galoshes, because it's pretty wet down there. We could just tell on that report. At the 19-yard line. Nick Foles going back to work, pump fakes, and that comes back across the middle in a first down throw to his tight end, who he's used quite a bit tonight, Terrence Miller.
And I'll tell you what, if Oregon's defense doesn't find some way to disrupt the rhythm and the flow that Nick Foles is in right now, they're going to have a difficult time all night, because he looks very comfortable. He's coming to second and third receiver options. He's getting good protection, and he's able to stay right in that pocket and deliver the football. And he's too good to let him do that.
Pick up of a couple for Antolin.
Again, not big yards running, but enough to make Oregon play both.
Right.
And that sets up some play action. And that just opens up other areas of your passing game if you run with some effectiveness.
Arizona take all the 16-play drives in the world you'll let them have, because they don't want Oregon on the field on offense either. So even though they go without a huddle, they're not hurrying as much as Oregon normally does on their offensive side of the ball. Foles, this time they get a little heat on him. He still got rid of it, and he might have a pass interference at the end of the play. Nope, no flag. Cliff Harris made the play defensively.
Well, a little bit of pressure. Foles had to step up in the pocket. He didn't get a whole lot on this football, and I think this was a pretty good play. Even though the right arm of Harris's was around Cobb's waist, I think he timed his contact with the football pretty well.
Straight down the middle, and it's intercepted by John Boyette. His fourth of the year. And that's Foles' first big mistake of the night.
Back-to-back throws, Foles made poor decisions. This one was high. The play before, he threw it low. This one, he threw it high, and Oregon got the football.
Thought about wearing that same helmet tonight. 14-14, Oregon leads the Pac-10. That was their 16th interception of the season, and it sets up their offense at the 10-yard line. Thomas on first down, wanting to throw, and the long ball, and incomplete, intended for Josh Huff. And you see the wet field. Josh went for a slide after trying to get to that ball. That interception by Poles, by the way, the first time in 92 pass attempts back to the first half against Stanford, the last time he was intercepted.
Yeah, that throw got away from him a little bit and sailed on it. The only good news is the defense gets to play with a big field.
Aaron Thomas shovel pass inside. LaMichael James broke a tackle, but he won't break the second one of Brooks Reed. And that'll bring up fourth down. You might actually see a punter tonight.
Well defended. You know, you hope to slip LaMichael James through on this. You let those guys rush upfield, but Brooks Reed was right on LaMichael James. I mean, it was almost like he was in man coverage on LaMichael James, anticipating that play, and they get the stop.
Give half of the credit to Ricky Elmore. He's the guy that made the first hit.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Out of the back of the end zone as Maldonado was set to punt. Drew Howell sent that one all the way to the end zone.
Well, Arizona will still get the football, but they'll also get 2 points on top of it.
Ooh, that one really took off. Now, the wet ball might have something to do with it. They try to get a dry ball out there every time, but on a snap that's basically 13 yards, that one went about 17. You don't ever get mentioned until you have a bad one when you're the long snapper.
By scoring and by hanging right with them.
Remember, there have been halves like this. At Tennessee, things weren't going so well for Oregon, and all of a sudden they just blew the doors off the Volunteers. So this one's a long ways from over. Beard will kick off on the free kick. You have the option to punt it or kick it. Beard will kick it. Mike Turner is the guy back deep. Nice kick all the way down to the 9-yard line, and good coverage as well. So not a lot of harm on the free kick. Avery Patterson made the tackle on the special team. Just with 4:36 to go till halftime and a 2-point lead, they'd love to get some more points out of this before the break. Foles off play action, deep middle, man is there and he's got him. Travis Cobb has got it all the way down inside the 35.
Again, play action. After the first down, make that defense play run or pass, and the play action brings the linebackers up and opens up things down the middle behind the linebackers, and Foles right on target with the football.
Actually, they spotted back out at the 36. But again, Arizona, all kinds of time. 31-yard pickup from Foles to Cobb. In the backfield with Foles on a first down, looking to throw, wanted to throw a screen, and he threw it right to the Oregon player, but he dropped it. Wow. Oh. Brandon Tett.
Well, first of all, it was an unblocked guy coming, Hannah, and Foles kind of panicked and tried to get rid of the football because he knew he had an unblocked guy coming at him, and he almost threw what might have been a pick six. As it turns out, it was just an incomplete.
So they live to play another snap here on second down and 10. Foles, a lot of time here. Comes back to his secondary receiver, Grigsby, broke a tackle, and another, and he's close to the first down, about a yard shy.
I'll tell you what I've been impressed with Nick Foles tonight, is the way that he keeps his feet alive in the pocket, and he keeps moving his eyes and his feet to different targets. Watch, he's looking left, now he looks middle, it's not there, comes all the way back to his outlet receiver on the opposite side. That's probably his fourth choice on that play, but that's a quarterback that's active in the pocket with his hands and feet.
Todd, that's the seventh different guy's hit, too, for 231 yards so far in the first half. Third down and a yard, maybe less than one, and Foles will do it himself. Todd said earlier, when you're 6'5", 245, you put your head down, and he did, and he got the first down.
Well, you mentioned Arizona wanting to score here again before halftime. They've got the 2-point lead. They need as many points as they can get against this team. And the other thing, with 3:32 and counting now, they would love to not let Oregon see the football again until they come out of the locker room.
That'd be perfect.
They've got a lot going for them right now on this drive.
They've been really good on third down. 6 of 9, the Wildcats, including that last one. Anthelin broke a tackle inside the 10, still going, and he's got another first down, first and goal for the Wildcats. pick up a 10 and his best run of the night. Junior out of Las Vegas.
Little counter play.
Took a good shot there and broke that one. And broke the second one, too. Inside the 5-yard line for Arizona, first and goal. And we're down to a minute 30. As Todd said, you don't want to give Oregon any time either. So they'd like to just take their time and get this 4.5 yards for a touchdown. Grigsby got back to the line of scrimmage. That's it.
Well, again, I think the key is a touchdown. You know, if they get the ball back with some time, but you get a touchdown, that's okay. But you don't want to have to settle for a field goal here. So Mike Stoops and his offensive staff, they don't want to be too conservative here. Even though they're letting the clock run down, a field goal only gives you a 5-point lead. That's a one-possession game against a team that averages 50 points a game.
Upcoming will be their 11th play of the drive. That's taken over 4.5 minutes. Grigsby in the backfield, but they got Kreiner down as a motion man to the right. There's the play fake. Foles is going to be sacked by Pacinger.
And if you call timeout and you throw again on third down.
Loss of 7 and a whole face full of dirt, or that Nike crumble stuff that's on the field in Nick Foles' face.
Now, again, you call timeout, which Mike Stoops just did.
Arizona.
You still think touchdown here.
Take another look at the last play.
This will be a 30-second charge timeout.
Pacinger beat the tight end, A.J. Simmons, coming around the edge and got the sack. You know, you hate to give up a sack there, but because Arizona had a timeout, they could stop the clock again.
Will they go back to one of his favorite targets, even though he's had 7 different ones? Or will it be somebody new? Kreiner is up to the top of your screen. 3 wideouts to the near side. 3rd down and goal, but the ball is way back now at the 12-yard line. Foles trying to get it to Kreiner, and it's out of bounds, and now they will have to bring out the field goal unit. Tell you what, if they get 3 out of a drive that ends the half after a fumble recovery when it looked like Oregon was going in, they'll take it. Zendejas, the snap was high, but the kick is good. Nice job by Kreiner getting the football placed for number 14. He kind of looks over at the Oregon sideline, shaking a finger as if to say, well, all that timeout stuff you did, coach, didn't do you any good, should say. At halftime, they go to the locker room on the road with a 5-point lead as we check in with Holly.
Well, coach, you told us you guys have not been a team to panic this year, but what concerns you most about these miscues, the snap out of the end zone, the turnovers?
Yeah, we got young kids snapping. We'll be okay. We shouldn't have turned it over down there, but we'll be okay. It's 30, 60 minutes of football, so.
Do you plan to use LaMichael James in the second half?
We'll see. No, I haven't heard anything from him, so we'll find out when we get in the locker room.
Okay, and then just how much confidence do you guys have that you've been so good scoring in the second half this year?
We got all confidence in the world.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Short and sweet for Chip Kelly. He's not worried. Well, they've proven in second halves all year long that they can come back and win. They're going to have to do it again.